That is true. Is what time of the day is it? Is it? It's like.
Fuck, that's a great question, man. Shit, is the stream started already?
Yeah, I just started it.
Oh hey! Okay.
Cool. Hey, everybody. Welcome to another game of D&D with the Dungeon Oasis. Appreciate you. If you want to come and watch all of our videos, come check it out on some YouTube action at Dungeon Oasis Streams. Come play with us on Discord. That'd be awesome. Appreciate you. And obviously, if you're here watching right now, you found us on twitch.tv/Dungeon Oasis. So, we're going to get back into where we were at. They had just finished out clearing the final boss fight for level one of this dungeon. Now, they haven't cleared out all of the dungeon, but there is a considerable amount of it now. Empty and devoid of all aggressive life forms. They've been traveling around with the Revenant. They've been calling Revy, or Rev, you know. Depends on who's who. And they got hurt pretty bad in that last fight. It was a rough one. So here we are leaving them in this room. Bodies everywhere. Charred and frozen and ripped apart and all kinds of things. Brains exploded. All kinds of ways to die that just happened. So here we are.
I'm on a tiger.
You are on a tiger.
Guys, we found the stairs. We should just go.
I mean, I'm not arguing with that.
Yeah,
no. Also, I think now that Revenant is at the stairs, he's not going to turn around.
Yeah, as you say that, he begins to walk downstairs.
What's your guys' health look like?
I'm doing pretty good. If anyone needs healing, I can heal.
I think Revenant took most of the damage.
He did take most of the damage. He tanked that battle.
Yeah, he is definitely, as he's going, like, pieces of him are, like, rushing to catch up and, like, reattaching themselves. And then, like, the parts that can't catch up, they just, like, wither away and become smoke. And then the smoke, like, goes back into his arm and starts to regrow. Like, parts of his arms are coming back. Like, he was missing a foot and, like, walking with a weird gait. And then, like, it's, like, baby foot, medium-sized foot. Full size foot, but like the fourth step as he's just walking along, he's regenerating all himself.
Rocket finds that absolutely disgusting.
This map is long.
A long map.
Sorry, I was looking for where you guys were actually supposed to be.
I was looking for where we were, too.
Yeah, well, you're not there yet.
I'm gonna cast a cure wounds.
We gotta walk down the stairs, guys. Everybody roll Constitution.
Alright, doesn't matter what you rolled, you failed. The save was a 34.
Oh no, I rolled a 1.
Excuse me? I'm starting a new bar somewhere else, bye.
I just tripped down the stairs.
Okay, something happened.
Are you on the right layer?
No, it's not that. It's that when I pull Alodia's out. It's your token.
Go back to the last map and just resave his token real quick.
Yeah, that's what I'm doing. And I was thinking about deleting your guys' characters off of this map, and I was like, no, I'm going to need it for something.
Muff, you're the most generous, friendly DM I've ever seen in my life.
Yeah, I was like, it'd be a little more dramatic if he, if D just died.
But that's...
You should have fucking murder-faced him.
I thought of that.
It would have been so much better if D made it back just carrying a dead RC.
Yeah, dude.
That's true.
That's what I was hoping for.
Just drops him. Is he alive? Nope. He dead.
I really hope Kissy's doing all right between, you know, all of her own streaming and everything. And we had one match earlier where they tried to hunt down the big bad of the area they're at right now, and the dude threw them in an illusion and took mind controlled one of the characters, so they're all having to fight this giant who was raging with a giant club and a giant axe.
Yeah, that was a rough fight. I did fine, of course.
I haven't killed anybody in a while.
Hey. Today's the day. Or maybe it isn't. Depends on how this first part goes, right?
I mean, I'm not DMing, so I ain't going to kill anybody. I learned how to fireball.
I was about to say, you got the fireball wand.
I learned.
You've been becoming a lot more magic adept.
You know, I don't know any pyrotechnicians, but I'm sure if I did, that they would sometimes be missing eyebrows and stuff. Absolutely. Yeah.
Got scars tell you exactly where they got it from, what caused it.
Oh, man, we are so small. This map is huge.
Jesus.
Yeah, why do you think it took me so long to get this ready?
God dang.
Do I still have my tiger?
This is bigger than the map that I put you guys on.
I forgot the tiger. Yeah, this is bigger than the last map.
No, I was saying this is bigger than the filler dungeon I put you guys in.
Mm-hmm.
Are these still 10-foot squares?
They are not 10-foot squares.
Cool. Yeah. Gigantic.
Oh, yeah. Shit, I still have to shrink you guys some.
I mean, I'm okay with, you know, being the ultimate halfling. Just the stoutest halfling ever.
It'd be like,
you add one of my skelly boys in also?
You'd have to be like flat to cover that much space. Yeah.
Even then, like starfished out, like still ain't gonna happen. I think I'm like 3'3" or something like that.
Right.
Yeah, 33 pounds. 33 years old. Faith, MOB. Money over bitches. Yeah.
MOB, except Rochelle.
Yeah, you know, well, hey, don't call her bitch, all right?
Well done.
I kind of refuse to believe that Dungeon the Mad Mage was created in 2018.
I refuse to believe a lot of things. How many skellies did you have left?
I don't think they even fought last fight, did they?
I thought they all died.
Sorry.
I thought they all died.
Three of them died. One of them is still alive. That's what I have on my paper. And he'll fill in the map when we came back to it.
All right. You got one skill.
Yeah, I have one.
Oh, I could go for a short rest at some point, though. I think we've
taken a long rest. You guys haven't taken a long rest in forever, and I'm just saying, you guys just keep charging on ahead.
I'm so Gucci. I don't need spells, so I'm fine.
Are you? No, we took a long rest.
Yeah, that was.
Yeah, and then we went through this big area that like kind of fucked us up.
Yeah, because I have a decent amount of spell slots left.
Okay, you were asking earlier. I was trying to remember what you were asking earlier, and you were asking what time of day it was around.
Yeah,
probably about I would say midday, or getting on towards the evening of the second day since you guys have been down.
Okay.
If not a little bit later than that, maybe getting towards dawn or dusk again.
Hey, Dottie, can you give control of the guy?
Oh, yep, that's important.
Oh yeah, I can't control him. Can't control Rochelle.
Well, yeah, you can't control her. She's too much of a woman.
She crazy.
It is the year of Rochelle.
Thank you. I think we're just waiting for Revy, right? Is he already here?
Yep, Revy too. So you guys are keeping me on my toes.
Well, we need Revy. Oh, we fought all the guys with Revy too, because he just kept on charging in, and we had to keep on fighting back-to-back battles.
Yeah, we did. We just followed him and handled what we had to handle.
Oh, I forgot about Revy. This is going to make this real interesting. This thing is so fucking glitchy sometimes.
It's because the map's so big.
Yeah, they warn you when you make a map giant like this. They're like, it's going to run slow.
I had that problem in my first Tyranny of Dragons game.
It's not normally this bad.
Once you put the characters on there, it gets worse. Especially if they like emit light and things like that. Yeah. And APIs really bad. I'm sure.
I don't have any API scripts. To be honest with you, couldn't even tell you what that is.
It's like cool little hotbar things that you can just make happen. Right away. Yeah. There's some helpful ones out there, for sure. Yeah. Anyone else have the We Don't Talk About Bruno song stuck in their head? Cool.
Yes.
The worst.
And the one that the Strong Girl sings too.
That's a great song.
It's a lot better than the Bruno.
Yeah. She's riding around on the unicorn donkey. Like, yeah.
Oh yeah.
Okay. So let's get interesting. You guys head downstairs after defeating all those numerous enemies in the floor above. What you're entering into, you hear the sound of hammering, as well as some squabbling in a language you don't understand. And beyond, you hear like shouting and the sound of numerous different, what you would assume is goblins. But it's not like an angry sort of shouting that doesn't seem like fighting at all. It seems like building and like maybe like a marketplace or something. You have a hallway here. And let's see, Clem 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60. Okay. Put that light out way further past than you can see. But you're at stairway, and you're coming towards the bottom of the stairs.
Hear that? Goblins equal mind players in my experience.
I don't really like anything down here, guys. I'm gonna be honest.
Yeah, that burping maniac is not a good decorator.
I mean, I guess that's not true. I do like you guys, and I'm glad that we're all on this journey together. But I don't really want to die.
It's fine if you die. I'll bring you back.
It's not all
scrapped up to me.
Elodia, you know, there was a time where if you told me that, I'd be like, yes, please do that. But I don't know if I want to come back like that.
I don't fear death. Die for my friends.
Yeah, you guys have also seen Virgil come back from the dead. Doesn't seem like that fun of an experience.
Well, Kelly here is fine. Revy's looking pretty good. I don't know what you guys are talking about.
Did you see him walk? He regrew his foot. Did you see him regrow his foot while he walked?
Yeah, it doesn't seem that bad.
I think Revy's already dead. You guys probably watched me regrow a brain.
That's true. I mean, I couldn't see that though. You know, like
true. We watched him regrow his foot.
I watched this guy Deadpool his hand back.
Like those things don't actually teleport into your head.
They bite through the front of your skull and eat your brain.
So
you just have this fat scar on your melon now?
Yeah, you got a big old forehead scar.
Metal.
It's anime as fuck.
Yeah, Clem does too. Oh
yeah. Yeah. Luckily I got skills to cover. Yeah.
Matching forehead scars, except lizard scars. Have you seen them things? They are vibrant.
We just got a headbutt now. We're gonna comment.
Right? It's just like, this is just why we have these scars. We promise. Headbutt. All right. So what's up, guys?
I'm just following everybody down.
Guess we're going south.
Yep.
I'm ready moving.
Yeah. Oh. Clem Dog, that's you? Okay. I'm trying to stay ahead. Revy, he goes, this way is one of them.
Well, leave the way.
still gonna let him lead the way?
You know I gotta be that guy, right?
Okay. All right, Rocket. How far can you see right now?
No, we have the Aurus.
I think we did the bubble, so that's our sight, right?
Yeah, that's
you got
yeah.
light going, right?
Yeah, so my aura is around my
your
lights
up to your aura.
Yeah.
Okay, so we're gonna go in two parts here. Right now, what you see is in top right there, Klimtok and Revy, you see a bunch of trash and debris on the floor. Boss reliefs adorn the walls. They look like they're dwarven bodies, but the faces have been chipped away, and on them have been drawn like cartoonish goblin heads with charcoal. And beyond, easily heard, is the sound of hammering grows louder through the northern passageway. And then, say what?
Go ahead.
All right. And then what you see in that little entryway is... you hear faint dripping to the south. Other than that, it's a long hallway ahead of you as far as you can tell. And you can smell water.
Like, does it smell like minerally well water, or like a river, or
it smells like minerally well water.
Okay. Yeah, I'm definitely the guy that peeks around the corner, but I'm not the guy that just goes by himself. But I would definitely like turn back and be like, we got some watery stuff back here. It doesn't smell like a sewer though, so that's good.
Well, I don't think we're going to be able to lead Revy any other direction.
Yep, good point.
If I go down and grab some of the garbage, goblins. Clearly apparent.
sir, that's racist.
It's only racist if it's not, if it's. Well, that he no he it, that's right. He's right. These are goblins for sure.
No, it's not the goblins.
I didn't say he was wrong.
It's the faces drawn on the stuff, not the trash.
Oh yeah, yeah.
Just totally missed the faces drawn on stuff.
It's not the trash.
That serves me. This way.
Oh.
Hey, dead meat. Where you going, man?
Well, he's going to get revenge.
I'm going to find him. Okay, one second. I have to figure out which room they're in.
Yeah,
he
we should just
literally
go.
Has a dead on like pinpoint to exactly where that guy's going to be.
I mean, also if we follow him, we're going to like another at least adventurer. So maybe we go a path that somebody's already cut their way through a little bit.
Judging by the last
one, I mean, he told us he was going to kill him.
Yeah. Well, I mean, either he dies or the adventure dies.
I don't think he can die until the adventure dies.
That's a fact.
He's got this.
Yeah, I mean, we don't.
I mean, you guys can totally just let him walk through there and just let him go. He will go.
Yeah, I mean, it's either we like follow him.
He did promise you guys a map.
That's true.
Like I was saying, we're going to meet up with adventurers who are going to die, and then you know we loot them.
I think we just kind of keep him in sight, or at least in sound. Like I assume he doesn't walk like a ninja, but as long as we're like keeping eyes on the paths that he walks by, because he obviously is not checking for traps and stuff like that, you know, like he's just going. So yeah, I don't know.
Yeah, he's definitely straight ahead, going exactly where he wants to go.
Is there a piece of charcoal on the ground?
Roll a perception check.
Nope, probably not.
No, not that you can see. Reach down, starting to grab something that looks like it was black, and it crawls away. It's just a cockroach.
Ew, ew, ew. This place is gross.
So, you guys do hear the sounds of multiple different voices speaking in Goblinoid, which you don't understand, back and forth to each other, and they are having a conversation in many conversations to your right, as well as hammering and banging up to your guys' north as Revy goes right.
Guys, I think we gotta make a decision. We following?
I'm following you, Clem.
I'm following Clem.
I'm just gonna uncover this whole place. You guys stumble upon an immense goblin market. It is a giant auction hall. Oh, wait, no, sorry, no. This is a market hall. It's a giant market hall. There are goblin vendors, and they're all hawking prices. Quite a few of them stop and stare as the Revenant just walks into the middle of the hallway. Stops for a second, looks around, finds a way around, and begins to stalk down and around the market stalls. Quite a few of them back away and try to distance themselves from the revenue.
I kind of just want to walk in and keep an eye on the revenue, but not act like he's my friend, you know?
Yeah, gotcha.
I just want to stay, like, right behind Clem, make sure I stay in his aura.
Can I see what's been sold?
Yeah, I was going to ask the same thing.
Yeah, I want to see what's being sold also. I need to sell some stuff.
There's all kinds of shit here. Like, there's all kinds of, like, weapons and tools. It's all a mishmash. Like, all the stalls seem to have all kinds of different stuff. Like, each of them looks like a thrift store. It's probably safe to assume they didn't buy all this stuff, and it probably didn't come, you know, a normal way. But they do have for sale all kinds of stuff, and they're not acting hostilely towards you guys.
Cool. Can I find someone who speaks common? Or just start shouting?
It would be, yeah, I was gonna say you can just ask somebody.
Yeah, I want to start shouting and see if anyone knows how to speak common.
Immediately hit, oi! What you want then? You know, we're not stupid. Most all of us can speak the common. We just don't like to.
Cool, I have things for sale. Does anybody need something or need to buy anything?
I'm not really in the market for anything but my safety right now. So
I'm gonna go to the first goblin and be like, hey, where you guys sell any healing potions anywhere?
Oh yeah, we got some fucking healing potions around here, this for sure. We got some oi! Even there, Jimmy, you got healing potions. Sammy has some too. Oh, and Clarence. Okay, here he is. We've got a couple of stalls around here that got some healing potions. Jimmy over there says he's got some.
I'm going to go up to this Jimmy guy. Does he point or
anything? Yeah, he points to one of the guys up to your north.
How far has the Revenant gone?
It's getting closer to these other doors, which have two goblins stationed outside. They're drawing their weapons.
That's gonna probably be bad. He's definitely gonna go through there. What's behind that door over there?
What's behind which door where?
I'm pointing at the door with the two guards.
It doesn't look like there is a door over there. Is there a door over there? Like, farther back? I guess I can't even see that far, so I don't know.
Well, this is all a lit up area, so.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, we're in a market now. They better not be in the fucking dark in a goddamn market.
I've ran Underdark adventures. I don't care where you are. Shit is dark.
Yeah, so up north you see a very large throne and more goblins up to the north.
Oh, a throne.
That's for me.
Yeah, I was talking about where the Revenant seemed to be going. I wanted to ask the shopkeep what that door led to.
Oh, that door there? Oh, yeah, that leads to Yik. He's leader. He's a fucking goblin pretending to be a human. He's wearing his stupid crown. He's got a prisoner in there right now. Some fucking unlucky dwarf.
I think that dwarf is gonna have a lot more bad luck coming his way with the way that guy's walking.
Oh, they won't let him in there, not without talking to, you know?
I don't think he cares if they're going to let him through.
I guess we'll see then, won't we?
You know, I'm trying to, like, help out, and you guys might just want to let him through. Because he looks kind of mean.
Oh,
and he looks like he's seen some shit.
Is he powerful or something?
I mean, with those scars, he's obviously been through some pretty tough battles.
Well, if you think he won't, you think he'll kill the king? That'd be cool.
What's that?
I'm sorry. You think he'll kill the king? That'd be pretty cool.
If the king gets in his way, he might. I'm pretty sure he's after the dwarf, though.
Yeah. Hey, Elfreda! You just let him on through, then. He says he'll kill you if you don't, and if you let him through, he won't kill any gobies. Oh, yeah, all right. Oh, you notice that the guards stand off to the side. They still have their weapons drawn and at the ready, but they aren't blocking the doorway.
Now would be a good time for somebody to turn invisible and follow them.
I'm going to go up to a gym stand and like try to twirl a platinum piece between my fingers. And like, here you got some healing potions, Jim.
Goddamn Rocket, what are you doing all the way up there?
I'm just looking. I'm
Did you sit in it, or are you just walking around it?
I'm just walking around it, but I'm about to sit in it.
I figured. God damn it.
I'm going to approach Clem and tell him the information I heard about the door and that the Revenant went into there.
Virgil by the, like, by the neck. It'll be all right.
It's a comfy seat.
I was gonna say, like, are you just being stealthy, or are you just walking up and sitting in the chair?
I mean, as stealthy as I can be walking up there with on a tiger.
Yeah. So, yeah, lots of people notice this because you are also the only people in here. So a lot of people have been checking you guys out, especially the one riding on a giant red tiger. So. The room goes silent.
I am the king of the dungeon.
Oh, shit. Clem, we should probably leave.
And then someone goes,
"This is now my throne."
Oi. Someone should tell Yek. This would be funny. Maybe he could get his ass kicked. Maybe Yek will get his ass kicked. Either way, it would be hilarious. Oh, Yek!
Someone sitting in the chair. Goblin homies, I am the king of the dungeon.
Mind if I go check on him? I can go get the king.
As that happens, you has heard a commotion start from in the room as the Revenant walks into the room Yek is in.
Yeah.
I didn't think you guys were going to fight these guys, but now we're at the point of no return, pretty much. You guys might be able to talk your way out of it. Yeah, but it's going to be a very interesting course of events. You heard a loud commotion start. As you heard some people like be like, "Oh, stop there, right there," and then just like, poof. "Oh, who was that?" And then somebody from the stalls said, "They said leave him alone there." "Oh, hey, Yek, someone's in your chair." And then you heard another voice go, "Who's this? Sit upon my throne. Get them." And roll initiative. I gotta do some math and other stuff.
I'd be like, who's getting them? Like, just the guards or everybody? Because everybody seems like they don't respect this guy.
You heard, get them.
I'm willing to fight everyone. I just wanted to say that out loud. There's a lot of things we could pick up.
Start out like and kick.
I figure I'm just watching Rocket and I didn't see any of this stuff go down.
I've got to find a way to make these dice quieter.
Just mute the tab.
No, that's way too easy. I don't want to forget to do that every time.
Should have a volume mixer for like chroma.
Yeah, I just found like the dice settings too, and I just turned that like way down. My song's dope as fuck, though. That's way better.
Okay. Well, this isn't the crazy hardest fight of all time, but this is definitely the most unnecessary. Here we go.
Define unnecessary.
Okay. We can never define unnecessary.
Because I just found a bunch of new subjects.
who told you throw a throne in front of Rocket?
No, King!
Surprise that Elodie's going to have some more silly boys. I need more to end with. I need to re-up after this battle, probably.
Oh, yeah. Oh, crap. I just made this encounter underneath the level 12 guys.
Or do I go right? You go left.
How about we both just leave?
Where's the fun in that?
Clem, I'm the king now. I found a throne.
God damn it. Why did we leave them alone all the time? Every time.
Virgil. You guys are going to be my knights.
Rocky, you might want maybe if we survive this.
I want to start calling people those cotton-headed naked muggins or whatever.
What? Oh. They don't know that I'm the king.
Being drawn around you all around.
They don't know. Oh.
I think we have to kill the other king first.
Well, bring him out then.
Are you issuing an official challenge?
I challenge the king to a duel.
Everybody hear that? You hear that? Duel.
We're
letting laughter. I mean, these are goblins.
Jim, discount on the healing potion and my guy wins. No goblins.
Like that. How many fireballs you got left?
I got enough.
We might be burning down the market.
This is not how I expected this would go.
I mean, last time we just talked our way through this. But,
hey, we got a bad initiative, guys.
Oh, yeah. Let's just put it this way. You guys went far enough to where they had to use multiple letters in the alphabet.
That's, you know.
That's superlative.
Now I just gotta put them all with colors. Then we'll be in there.
Good luck with that.
Yeah, I don't think there's enough colors in the rainbow.
I did groups of five.
I think you fucked up.
That'll be fine.
We still might not have enough colors.
Virgil, five gold. Revy's dead.
I mean, he was already dead, so I'm not taking that bet because that's an obviously
that's a pretty safe bet.
You got me. Double dead.
That said, they're not mad about Revy. They're mad about Randy.
Can
I was going to say, I don't know if Revy's in trouble right now.
Can I use...
Don't give a damn about Revy.
Can I use the opportunity of seeing everybody look at me to, like, just take my tan bag of tricks and just flip it upside down and dump the last two balls out?
Yeah. Yeah, I'll give everyone a single action as, like, you guys notice things turning south quick.
Where are we on the turn order?
Doesn't matter.
Yeah, because I don't even see us on the bottom.
Wait. Oh shit, did it cancel you guys out when I refreshed it and not add you guys into it?
Yep.
Do you have it on Beyond?
Yeah, it shows you guys on Beyond.
I don't know, Mike.
Might have broke the encounter tracker.
Yes. I got a baboon and a black bear.
Yeah, it still doesn't show you guys. Yeah, and I don't even know what they're doing with all these AH and AA. It's like goes through ABCD, or it just has AAABAC. Oh my god, dude.
I don't know if it's possible.
AGAI, what the fuck?
It's possible to roll just like, I don't know, like however many, five.
See, I have them grouped in groups, like groups of five, and then that's how it should be doing that.
Sorry, folks, we're experiencing some technical difficulties.
Yeah, sometimes numbers are too much for computers.
All I know is Sir Bernard B. Bear and Barry Baboon are at my side.
Okay, I will get to that.
It's fine. I'm just gonna like put some little drawings up there.
I mean, I rolled an 18.
I rolled an 8.
Hope it works this time. Yes, still are in it. Okay, all right, we'll do it this way then.
Oh, I can't group them. I just have to cover it all. All right, we got this.
Okay, I'm almost there, I promise. I just have to manually add you guys all in here. And also get Revy's ship up.
Well, I think I'm actually too big again. Because I had to delete my token and bring it back out on the thing. Cool. I'm very impressed by the drawing. Well, thank you. I zoomed all the way up to 250%.
Hard to do with the mouse.
I gave the baboon a red butt so you can differentiate the two. Yeah.
Sorry, this is taking longer than I was hoping.
Who wrote Farty Head, Dom?
You just now seeing that?
Yeah. I was zoomed in 250%, drawing my baboon butt. It's nasty graffiti.
Okay, so
Dottie, I'm sorry that I'm king.
It's all right. So you're right after Goblin and Virgil. I don't even know how these ones with the multiple. I don't even know how these ones with the multiple letters and like work.
I mean, they start with the single letters, I assume. And then the second set is A, A, B, A, C, A, D, etc., etc., etc. Remember when earlier we were talking about not having a room with 100 people?
Yeah, we were.
Okay, cool. As long as we're on the same page.
But here we are.
Here we are. I assume the king doesn't accept my formal challenge.
Oh, he does not.
Sounds like a punk ass mark to me.
You just go in there and shoot him.
Just a mark ass bitch.
Trick ass hoe.
I'm almost there with the clip, with the turn order, guys. There's just so.
I mean, I'm going last anyway, so I'm chilling. Well, I guess I'm going before
Logan. Yeah,
it
is actually really helpful that you guys rolled so low.
I'm going after Clem, before Elodia. Virgil might escape.
I'm going to escape right into the throne room and shoot that dude in the face.
I think we'll be fine.
You got my bag, Virgil? Virgil? Virgil!
And where did Virgil go? I need my knights up here. Things are not looking good.
Coming.
Where's my Merlin? Elodia, you're my Merlin.
I have no idea what's happening, by the way. I rolled a 1.
Yeah, but you're up there with me. You know. You know.
Yeah, I'll find out after they start hitting me.
Okay.
Lydia, you saw me sniffing around up there, and you saw me adjusting my crown before I sat down.
Yeah, I was paying attention to you. I was wondering what you were doing.
You knew.
Obvious red flags.
Where did this king thing come from again?
I got a crown bestowed upon me.
Oh, we went back into the room that everybody was turned to stone, and we took it off the statue.
Yeah, but something else told you were the like ruler or something. I remember that.
No, the mirror told me I was not the ruler. And I argued with it. So far, no one has actually told me I'm king. But me. Take that for...
The only voice record.
Yeah.
Right? The only one that matters.
I will take into account what other people say, but at the end of the day, if Rocket's got his mind set on something, that's what he's doing. Usually gets him into trouble.
Okay, I accidentally put too many.
Got him a wife, though.
Okay. One time got him a wife, though.
So, you know, it's like a little small child. You know, like, yeah, we could have ice cream after dinner one night. So every night I'm going to be like, can I have ice cream after dinner? We don't even have ice cream, but can I have some? You know, like,
yeah, it's even worse that it was the first time.
Yeah, exactly. Like, that's it now. My intuition is what led me to this point. It might be my undoing. We'll see. My first proclamation as king is everybody love everybody.
I really thought that you guys were going to fight all these guys.
Come on.
Okay, yeah, come on.
Waited 2 weeks so that we can.
Yeah, I'm just kicking myself now. I'm just like, yeah, no, I shouldn't have thought that.
It's always the thing you don't think of as the DM that the party does. Just
at least you put all the goblins down.
Yeah, I was so ready for you guys to have a nice like shopping episode.
Oh no, all they have is garbage.
No, that's next.
We're still gonna have a shopping episode.
But we're instead of shopping, we're just gonna take it all.
We're gonna take it.
We're gonna leave our trash, take anything that's worth anything, and you know.
Yeah, we're the pissed off athletes.
Fucking kill Rick.
I honestly want to offload all my weapons that I've been hoarding the entire time, but yeah, I'll pick it up more.
I'm gonna change my name to Joffrey. That's a joke. I'm not gonna do that. Joffrey is a punk ass bitch.
Got him. I've almost marked them all, guys.
Muff, what days can you play? Is it Wednesday and Thursday?
I'm off Wednesdays and Thursdays, but I could really play anytime. I can only play after midnight my time, so that's 10 o'clock y'all's time.
I mean, that works perfect for me.
Yeah. So I mean, I think the only time slot we have open right now is like Sunday and Friday.
I'm just putting together another like mini adventure, and I like playing with you.
Oh yeah, I mean I'm down. Just gotta tell the wife.
I feel that.
All right, so I was gonna do it by the letters, but because of all the double letters, we're just gonna go like first five goblins are one color, so on and so forth. So here we go. You hear bickering coming out of the hallways to your west, where you heard the banging, which the banging has now stopped. And you hear sounds kind of inquisitive sounds coming that way. Nothing like overtly rushing out to combat. Then you hear two bugbears coming rushing towards the doorway.
Is this coming from like here?
From the southern, from the southeastern doorway.
Oh, down here? Or like all the way down here? Okay.
The room that the Revenant went into.
You just said west at first, so I assumed it was this one next to me.
Yeah, good call. I didn't specify.
I should have grabbed a beer.
You got time.
Yeah,
I'll be right back.
Yeah.
But if I die, I at least need to be feeling it. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I was going to say 100%. Like, you got time. I got a lot of things to move around until you get back. All right. So then... that one doesn't do anything. Oh no, that one sees, and you guys hear an excited voice saying like Chittering Goblin. Oh, you're not quite understanding what it says, but you hear just a collective like and then this one stands there. Circles are there, and starts to shout at Rocket. Doesn't have any weapons out. These two pull to the side. This one does charge full on weapon brandished. He looks like he's coming to try and get his murder on. Virgil, you are up.
So, are those goblins near me? Or the shopkeepers still nearby?
Yep. Yeah, you got goblins on both sides of you.
So, I'm going to casually just kind of talk to the ones in the stall. Just let out a large sigh. Be like, God damn it. So, you said your king has been acting like a little bitch, right? Has anything weird been about him?
Well, he's got this fucking circlet on. He just always wears it. Makes him look like, the one up there with the skeleton by him. It makes him look like a human like that, yeah? Just like perfect. Like Adonis. I guess that's what he keeps saying anyways. I just don't get it. It ain't right, yeah? He's being led by leading a bunch of goblins looking like a fucking human. This is not right, yeah?
Yeah, it's very odd. So was he, like, super cool before he found this weird thing?
Oh, he's always been a straight prick, yeah? Well, at least he was a goblin prick.
Yeah, I can see that. So, what say we take care of him for you? Either we get rid of the thing making him act all human-y, or, we tell him what for.
Oh, well, most of us here is just doing a job, so we'll probably not get in the way of any mishappens that might happen, you know? But the guards, they'll be fighting, for sure. There's a one less head on a one less body, you know.
All right, well, I thank you.
We'd rather you just took circlet from him, but honestly, to be real with you, I'm just tired of his shit.
Yeah. I'll go see if I can have a word with him. Thanks for the heads up. I'll toss him a gold coin.
Oh, thank you. Thank you very much. Oh, man, it's real, too. Chip my tooth.
You, might want to, try drinking some milk.
Oh, this is nasty. We just got spider's milk in here. You don't want to drink that.
So I'm going to, head towards that door where the king is.
The bottom right side of the map. You can't cut through in between the stalls. They are all very closely back together.
And then for my bonus, I'll go ahead and make the clone. Boom.
Am I dead yet?
Not yet.
About. We're getting there.
Cool.
All How big is your giant baboon? Is it just a medium or is it large?
Oh, you're going to give me. That berry is a small beast. So he's the same size as I am.
That's weird. A giant baboon is small.
It's not a giant baboon. It's just a baboon.
Okay, yeah, that makes sense. For my action, I'll take the dodge stance.
All right, sounds good. And you are... Okay, gotcha. So that's your clone down there?
Yeah.
Bernard B. Bear's medium.
I like that bear. That's a bear.
There you go. You got access to them both.
Yeah, Rochelle's the only thick girl. As is tradition.
As is tradition. All right. Is that everything for you, then?
Yeah, that was my action bonus.
All right. You hear... No. 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 Oh. And then just a bunch of goblinoid. Well, I don't think that's right.
I forgot, like, the map sizes were weird.
Yeah. This one hovers for a second. He stops, like, hearing the sounds coming from in there, and shakes his head, and he runs off towards Rocket as well. Oh, I accidentally resized it. Doing a full dash past your skelly boy there, Olivia.
Do I get back opportunity or no?
You can if you wish.
If I shoot him with a short bow, because that's what he has, is that disadvantage?
It would be disadvantage, yes.
Okay. 15?
15 will most likely hit the gobby.
So it does
that
damage.
Is their armor class, yes.
Cool.
As that one has a shield and a mace.
Oh, he also has to roll a con save, because if you run within 10 feet of me.
Oh, yep. True that. But that doesn't matter, because he did.
Oh, never mind.
As he goes through, like, as he's, like, running past, he kind of, like, starts to swat at himself as, like, kind of cough a little bit, and he looks up just as an arrow just comes through his eye at the back of his head and just drops. This one here, yeah, he's still screaming. But he stops yelling in Goblin. And starts yelling in common, saying, "Oi, it got a whole bunch in the other room there. He's going to kill your ass for this. Oh, shit. Oh, all right, well, you guys fucking do your thing then, I guess." These ones here, as the guy you were talking to, he yells something out. He goes, "Oi, it's we ain't fighters, yeah."
Good choice.
One of them is nodding, and he says, "But we are goblins!" He runs up behind you, and he goes to try and whack you with his scimitar.
Bad choice.
Hey, that is what life is. Good choices and bad choices.
Oh, yeah.
And 8's not going to hit you, so...
I'm going to pick that up later.
Yeah, so that's his turn. And Virgil, this other one's like, "For the goblins!" Eleven to hit. Oh, disadvantage, so... 7 to hit.
Hey, chill, dude, chill.
So you hear a couple of roars as you hear some swings going on inside and what sounds like a scuffle ensuing in the king's room.
You mean my room?
Yeah, it's a pitched battle going on in there. Clement, it is now your turn.
Okay. First off, I'm going to hit this guy.
Smite the fuck out of that guy.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
11 plus 1.
Oh, he did.
Told you, made a bad choice.
I just assume you turn and look at him as he stabs and just chinks off your armor and you're just like, bad choice, and then just fucking upward strike, just cut him in half.
Absolutely, that's exactly what happened. Alright. That's gonna be... So, the blue ones are attacking, or just the one to the right of...
That one's charging. That one yelled something and is charging.
Okay.
The one on the left of Elodia, was yelling, and then he saw what happened to the first guy, and he's like, "Oh, well, yeah, you guys fucking do you then."
Okay. I'm just gonna point my finger at this orange one over here. He's like, "Hey! Better stand down," and that'll be my turn.
Roll an intimidation check.
Okay.
Oh.
He just looks at you and goes, "Actually, I'm gonna roll it. Let's see."
He's one of the ones that
doesn't
speak
dice
common.
Yeah, with a minus one, he still rolled an 11. He's just like, "Fuck, back and jump!" And he like does the whole like flick under the chin at you.
Ah,
shakes his fist.
This one's stupid, guys.
Gobby life. So watching you casually cut one of their other friends in half, these other shopkeeps. So. Go back to their storefronts. Rocket, you're up.
Just want to start with friends, subjects, people of the court. Halt before something bad happens. And
roll a persuasion check.
Okay. That's 26.
Okay. I'll keep that in mind.
And then I say, Rochelle, and like point my finger, sending Rochelle to this one here. And then I also say, or you could be like this fool over here and point at the other blue one on the other side of Elodia and cast Vicious Mockery on that one.
Okay. It's a wisdom save, right?
Yeah.
That doesn't pass.
Well, 3 points of damage, but a disadvantage. And then Rochelle's... That's
enough to kill that one.
Okay.
I'm doing this health a little different. Basically, I'm pooling all of the Gobby's health together. So all the damage you do, I'm just killing them off as it goes down with the total damage you do.
So it's like minion tactics. I like it.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, so you drop that guy. Which is effective for your speech.
Does an 11 hit for Rochelle?
Oh, that one wasn't fighting you guys. But yeah, it does hit. No, 11 doesn't hit. Even without their shield, it doesn't hit.
Okay, she doesn't have a multi-attack, so that is that is it for me.
All right.
I say once again, I only challenged the king, as he is not the rightful ruler. And that is the end of my turn.
Okay. All right, this guy runs at Virgil, yelling, "They're going to kill us all!"
Well, you guys really need to chill out.
He swings at your... They're not the smartest fucking... They're not the biggest chip off the block there.
I've kept it pretty simple for him. Right.
Yeah, we're just going to leave that as that doesn't hit. This one here. See, these are guards, though. They are not swayed by your... They're swayed by the money in their pockets right now.
They don't even know how much money could potentially be in their pockets.
You also didn't mention that.
That's true. I just want to talk to the king so he can bow down before me. Or die.
13 doesn't hit you, does it, Virgil?
My clone or me? Either clone. Way, 13 is no.
I was about to say, does it matter? You have the same AC.
No, we don't.
Oh, okay. Sure. Couple more guards come charging up at you. All right. Then a bunch of goblins come flooding out, and they are all dressed differently. Like, it looks kind of like formal wear almost, but they're all holding, like, daggers with, like, meat on the end of them. Some of them are still trying to eat it. They're all kind of just running out screaming, like, arm flailing. Like, I would say the best description would be, like, grunts in Halo after they figure out they can't win. And they just run away, like, ah!
Solid.
Elodia, you're up.
Oh, cool. 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30. I get to here 30 feet of movement, correct?
Yeah.
Cool. I want to move to there. Yeah, I'm just gonna throw daggers. So who is currently coming at us? This guy and this guy.
Yeah, those two.
Cool. I could throw two daggers. Both of them, because it doesn't say that I have to throw the same one. I just have to throw both.
Throw two daggers.
So this is for the one closest to us.
That one is not a guard, so he will not be wearing a shield. So that will just hit his AC.
That hit?
Yes.
All right. 6 damage.
Ooh. That is enough, I think. Yep, exactly enough to kill him.
Cool, man. With my next dagger, I want to hit this one over here.
All right.
That kills him. 21.
Definitely hit. This one is a guard.
3 damage.
Catches him in the shoulder a little bit. He stumbles, but he's still coming at you.
And then... the end of my turn, and then for my skeletons, no, my bonus action, which would be my skeletons' turn. The short bow goes up to 80 through 320, so I should be able to hit.
Yeah, you
him
can
again.
That's not gonna hit though.
That misses. I probably hit the stall at this point, and then just whoops, that's it.
That was almost a string snap. It was real close. All right, then everything then? Moving on to more hobbies. So, a bunch more goblins come running out, and then a tall, finely dressed man with a golden circlet on his head comes out. Says, "Now, why are we having this issue? You should be helping me, okay?" And then the ones that were running away, screaming kind of in fear, stop and with looks of adoration on their face, they kind of shake themselves off and look at you guys menacingly.
Who's that? This guy right here?
Yep.
He's got the circlet?
He got the circlet.
That's what I want.
All right.
If you'll allow me to point at him, I'll do that.
Go ahead. Point away, my friend. Point away. Just like, I'm just picturing Evil Monkey from a Family Guy.
I mean, I'm not as menacing looking, but after my speech, you know, like if that's what happens, you know, I'm talking to you. I tried to keep my speech to under 6 seconds.
It was one of those quick hits. So you being the one who did all that, let's see here. See if he can charisma his way over. No, he physically can't. Okay. I was gonna say maybe he can out charisma you. And I was like, will you roll the 26? He has a -1. That's not happening.
Good fucking luck.
Yeah.
I'm an eloquence bard. Good fucking luck.
Maybe on like a fucking fart on a whim that he might be able to get that, but no, it ain't happening. So yeah, all right, two bugbears come charging on out of there. Most of the goblins still stay cowered on the sides. Those two go forward. That one stabs you again, Virgil, saying, no! George was my friend! Oh, those are 2 8s. I assume that's not going to do it. So, Virgil, you're up. This guy is just trying his damnedest.
Okay. I wonder if my clone can engage.
I mean, you could resummon it next turn once, just dip.
It doesn't say anything about it being able to do that. I'm going to have the clone walk forward.
I can't hear you if you're still talking, Dom.
No, I'm still trying to do stuff.
Okay. All right,
So I walked away from these goblins. I suppose they're going to try to attack.
Yeah, he's going to give it a go. He feels real confident in himself. 15?
No.
Yeah.
All right, then I'll use my bonus to swap places with my clone. And again, take my action to dodge.
Okay. Is that everything, or do you have more?
Yeah, that's action, bonus action, movement, all that.
All right. You hear a scream, and then silence, and then Revy. Pops around the corner, you can barely see him.
Oh, so I guess there's more.
He goes, one more down. The other is this way.
All right, well, I already warned them about him, so.
What direction does he point?
He points back out the way you guys came in.
Oh, lovely.
Oh, actually, he points that way, and then he also points south.
So, like, towards the corner down here? Okay.
I'm guessing, it's like, well, I guess, supposedly he doesn't know the way. He just knows the direction the person's in.
Yeah, that's what I was saying. I assume he just, like, points to the bottom corner down here, like he's that way.
Yeah, he points to a few different locations, because there's still two more left alive. He points to those two locations. But they're not together. Oh. Sorry, goblin's turns. Shit, where are we at with all these fucking gobbies?
I mean, if they could just give up, you know, this would go a lot quicker.
So, the thing is, most of them aren't trying to get in the middle of this fight. Most of them don't like this king. But there is a few of them that really do. And because of this fucking ridiculous amount of them, I've lost track of which ones care about and don't care about the game.
That's valid. I'll kill them all if that means I'm in charge.
Maybe that's what the double letters were for.
This is a valid point. I don't think that's right, but valid point nonetheless.
That still might have been too many. Yeah, that's actually about right. Yeah, fuck it. We'll do that. Double letters are the ones that care about the king. It's actually not a bad system. So this guy comes running at Elodia because the dagger facing him. And he's going to swing at you with his scimitar. With his scimitar!
On Elodia? Doesn't he have to make a con save first?
Yeah, he has to make a con save.
Con save first, you're all right.
That's what that little gray circle in between me is.
That is a 2, so I'm assuming that doesn't pass.
Cool.
Passes right into the realm of death.
Almost. 3. Real fucking close.
I gotta set that circle a little bigger. 10 feet, not 5.
That is only an 11 to hit you.
Oh, that doesn't hit.
Yeah.
That wouldn't even hit me.
Alright, so we're gonna go. This is so many people. Fucking moving around your D.
Delete the artwork, dog.
Yeah, you can delete all of it.
Yeah, I know.
I think it's easier for you to do it, though, because you can highlight it all. He can't.
I completely forgot about that.
I can just click two buttons and clear it all. All drawings have now died upon the map.
I had a beautiful bear, though, that would have also perished in that moment as well.
Yeah, but you have an actual bear now, though. So.
That is true.
14 doesn't hit your clone, does it?
No. Oh, that's me, by the way. I'm down there now.
Oh, that's you?
14. Yeah, the clone has the black symbol on it.
Oh, gotcha. We'll see what the third attack might do. Hit.
At disadvantage.
It was a 21 and a 23.
I'm guessing this is the bugbear.
Nope. Still just a gobby. It's only 7 damage.
Are the bugbears like on either side of this gold circlet guy?
Yep.
Cool.
Okay, I did use my active one.
I just sneezed and bit my tongue. It was horrible.
I haven't done that in a long time. Bit my cheek a lot.
That's terrible.
Doesn't feel good.
All right, Clem, you're up.
All right. Moving in. Should put me in range, I believe.
Yeah, that'll hit. And his thieving days are over.
Yeah, I'm just going to stay there and that'll be the end of my turn.
All right, perfect. Yeah. You guys trying to come by? You got to make it by me.
You, it's our night. When is me and my brothers on our mission to Camelot?
What? This is Camelot?
Yeah. That's what we're telling people now.
Okay. Yeah. Yeah, you got it.
You're the king of Camelot.
All right, Rocket, you're up.
I keep my hands raised in the air. You continue to watch your brothers be slain, and I say again, it is only your king I wish to face, as I like shake my hand in like Dave Chappelle type vengeance. Um Did this guy do anything? This blue guy up here?
Even he's the one that was yelling at you to be careful, and then after you guys killed the first guy, he was like, oh, yeah, never mind, do you.
Okay, so, like, Rochelle, like, has he had a turn since Rochelle got in his face?
He has. He's been just groveling.
Okay. Yeah, I just want to continue to plea my case that, like, we don't need to fucking kill everybody in here, but we will if that's what it comes down to. Like, who's the boss? Like, bring out the boss. That's what I'm trying to portray.
Of course I'm the boss. Now kill this imposter. The guy with the circlet yells from the other side.
Like, you just got a circlet, bitch. I got a crown.
But you're not as beautiful as I am.
Screw. I'm sorry, what did you just say?
You've seen this visage, this physique. Of course, I am the most finest specimen of all the lands of any humanoid creature ever created.
I run, jump on Rochelle's back, and I'm just like, yeah, bitch! And she starts running that way.
Yeah, bitch!
Yeah, she moves 40 feet and she's going to dash. So that's 80 feet.
Yeah.
How far can I get 80 feet?
Each of the squares is 10 feet. So
okay, so 8 squares.
Yeah.
Yeah, I pull up right here next to Clem, sitting in his aura, just like, skirp! And I just point at him. Me and my champion against you and your champion. What say you, knave?
He says, oh, hilarious. You would think I'd fight you myself. Kill them.
I look at Clem and I'm like, this guy's a fucking idiot.
Yeah, he sounds like a big old puss.
Yeah, and that's I guess I didn't do an action, did I?
No, you didn't.
It's about time I fireball this general area.
Yep, I kind of figured that was about to happen. Yeah, so that's a lot of decks. How much you just roll some damage? We'll see. Well, I'll do deck saves for the bugbears.
I gotta see how many charges I have left. I don't want to burn this wand up.
Oh, yeah, this is gonna be rough.
But I am willing to use all but one charge of it for sure.
As I see Rocket doing that, like, easy on the market, bud. Gotta get our loot, you know.
Ravi's also over there.
He'll be fine.
Yeah, I'm not worried about homie.
Go for the market. Don't worry about the guy that was traveling with us. He'll be okay. Which ironically is true. You guys couldn't rebuild the whole market. Revy will just grow back.
Yeah, we're doing 3 charges for a 5th level fireball. 43 points of damage.
Where are you putting that thing at?
What up, Darth?
Well, Clem said to you know, be mindful of the market, so I just put it on the wall, like, right there.
He did.
Because it's 20 feet, so that should just go to the other side of the bugbear and homie.
Okay, so God damn, I just moved a bunch of them to the map layer.
Like the worst layer to move things to.
Just take the big map and switch it to the DM layer real quick, and then send it back to the map layer.
Idea. Oh, yeah, because that would send them to the bottom, huh?
Mm-hmm. I've done that numerous times.
Wouldn't it also send everything on the map to the bottom?
Nope. Well, yes, but you can right-click the map and say send to back, and it will just go to the back and keep everything else in front.
Oh, yeah, I have to use that a lot.
Well, I didn't remember those tokens, though.
Did I kill them all?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was every one of the last ones that were against you. Except for two bugbears, which were attacking Revy, and Revy got hit pretty hard. But he walks out, smoking a little bit, saying, "Oh, no friend, you hit Revy with fire again. Revy does not like fire. It takes a long
time." Oh, yeah. Revy, you know, I'm sorry. There's this guy with a gold circlet. He thought he was the king. I am the king. So I just had to show, I had to assert my dominance.
Oh, I killed another one of the party.
You killed the guy? That's exactly what we're trying to do.
I smushed face.
Yeah, perfect. You know, you keep smushing face, and I will keep lighting things up around here. But I'll try not to hit you. I do apologize.
I would appreciate not getting hit to me.
I feel like you're okay, though. Are you okay?
I'll be okay in 5 minutes.
Cool. Clem, I really don't care if I hit him. Is that bad?
Well, you gotta do that.
Nah, he's just a dead guy, man. I mean.
Okay, cool. Like, as long as I just don't feel bad. So, if... Yeah, I will never do that again, Revy. You know, like, I mean, well, I can't say never. I literally almost blew us all out of an elevator before. So, you know, promises, promises. But I will do my best.
Okay. Tell long furry arm ones that I do not want to fight them. I will kill them too.
I mean, you can kill them if that's what you need to do. You can totally, you know, nobody will be mad at you.
All right, you heard him. I can kill you if I want to. You just hear like, oh? And then like you see a bugbear like poke his head around the corner and see just like a massive just like
pile of ash in front of him.
Just like pile of ash, just like blood, just like parts, and they go, just drop their weapons and back
off. I just like look at him like, I mean, point at my crown.
Yeah, they just put their hands up and they back off. All the gobbies, they just like, for a second, it's just quiet. And then all of a sudden, they're like, you just hear the guy that you talked to originally. It's like, well, that's not exactly what we was thinking of it going down. But I guess, it's sometimes it's better one way than the other. It's, thank you, thank you.
Anybody else want to end up like these fine folks over here?
A bunch of shaking heads as you guys get out of it.
Who's the king?
Oh, you're the king, mate. You're the king.
Somebody take that crown from them, please.
No, how? Virgil, I will fire you.
Rocket, how do you think your wife would react to you acting like this?
I'm sorry.
$763 apiece.
I mean, if we're being honest here, my wife's only my wife because I came in and dominated the fuck out of her husband.
God damn it.
So
when you put it like that, that's terrible.
I'm gonna grab
like he's back at home making us fucking liquor, all right. And she's in my bed.
As far as you know, you guys have been gone like a whole day long.
I mean, if not, I'll fucking kill him. Rocket's gone dark. Rocket's gone dark lately, guys. Like he watched.
I mean, that's why you leave him with the necromancer all the time.
He watched Clem and Virgil get their brains eaten out. Like Elodia just summons dead things around him now. Like, you know, he's not as pure as he once was.
I'm gonna grab that circlet.
Can you top the XP? Hey, I'm level 15.
Funny. All right.
I'm going to go into this room, by the way.
Which room?
The one that Revy came out of.
Oh.
I'm going to be like, Clem, which one said they had the health potions?
Jim. I don't remember which one's Jim.
Jim, who the fuck is Jim? Jim.
Oh. You killed Jim.
Oh, damn. Perfect! Clem, all his health potions are yours.
Is that how that works?
Did the circlet survive the blast?
The circlet did survive the blast. Clem Talk has already grabbed it.
Okay, good. Oh, we can sell that.
I'm just kind of casually walk up and start clearing out old Jim's shot.
Okay. So, I would say, okay, this is an interesting one. So
I am going to take my earpiece and put it on the throne.
Okay.
That doesn't work.
I think, like, we've already established it doesn't quite work like that.
What?
Like, as a bug?
No, I'm gonna teach one goblin how to use it. Be like, if anybody comes in here and does anything, this is how it works. And you let us know.
You sure you want to set up shop on the second floor of this place?
Yeah, look at all these guards.
But they're all goblins.
Yeah, they're all fucking terrified of me. It's fine.
it's like the chihuahua who's found a dog that is scared of it.
Yeah, like they. I'm not worried about them anymore.
Judging by the first floor, we might be on this floor for a while.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. I'll appoint someone else king of this floor later as I go to conquer the next floor.
Okay. Well, I suppose that's fine, I guess.
Bad thing is if Rocket goes off by himself.
Yeah, he doesn't have
any enemies anymore.
I might give up my headset to Rocket at this point.
That doesn't help since you two are the ones who always run off together.
As long as one of us has a headset, it's fine.
That's true.
All right. Klimtok, roll a D100. Elodia, you walk into that room, and it is a more finely appointed room than the others. Has a large plinth with pillows surrounding it. And a throne, and just like, but it's like all cascaded in pillows. And at the southern wall where you're standing in front of is the smashed in face of a dwarf, as well as the rest of the dwarf. But it looks as though through blunt force impact, the dwarf's face and upper body were pummeled to death.
Cool. Does he have anything on him?
Yeah. There's a bag next to him. In the bag is a potion of healing. One second.
BRB, I'm gonna run in the bathroom.
Oh, that was the wrong one. Well, keep that potion healing anyways. Fuck it.
Cool.
You can do an investigation check to check the body.
So, no bag, just we'll just say a potion of healing?
Yeah, no bag. We'll just say you see a potion of healing laying on the ground next to him, but you can do an investigation check to check the body. Oh, very good. Cool. So, betwixt his bunions, you can take that how you wish.
Okay.
But his buttocks bequeaths to you a map.
Cool. Well, I'll take the map.
All right. It is not in the best condition right now, with large stains of what you could only assume. And as, you know, the person whose buttocks it was hidden betwixt recently died, and as death does, your liquids get eviscerated. So it's not a great map to hold in your hand right now.
Cool. Where's Rocket?
Oh, I'm back on my throne.
Oh, you don't have your headset. Virgil, where's Rocket?
I was not watching Rocket.
I'm on my throne.
I see the tiger over that way.
I'm like setting it down. I'm like, oh, Elodia? Do you need something?
Something got keistered. We need it cleaned. You're the one.
Oh. What is it?
A piece of paper. I think it's a map.
Someone boofed a map?
Yeah, someone boofed a map.
Oh, Jesus. Bring it out. I'll do what I need to do. I'm not going to touch it, though.
I don't know, man. This one might need some pretty in-depth prestidigitation.
I'll use two hands for prestidigitation for sure. But yeah, as soon as Lodi gets over there, I'll sit on my throne like the high and mighty halfling I feel like right now, and prestidigitate the map.
I'll pardon you.
There's a map. It looks as though it is the floor of the dungeon. And you're not quite sure what floor it is.
Cool.
It's not the first floor.
You are pretty certain it's not the first floor. It doesn't match any of the layout that you've been in there.
Virgil, come talk. Who wants the map?
I'll take the map.
I'm not holding that thing.
Cool. Clem got the map. We're handing it off.
Virgil, it's clean. I washed it.
I'm a magical genius. I'm not too good with maps.
I'm a goddamn magical genius. I'm getting like a little Kanye syndrome going, you know?
Yeah, I was about to say, you're getting to where you're just like, I am the greatest.
Prove me wrong.
I would even just a cursory glance at it from where you're at with your intelligence check that you rolled earlier, that does not match up with any of the areas that you've seen so far in here. Like, even this one room that you're in, the shape of this room doesn't match up with any of the other rooms in the other map. You can assume that it's of not this floor either.
Household Jim Bob's shop.
Oh, yes. So, you weren't able to find very much. You were able to find a health potion in there. You were able to find quite a few tids and tads of weapons, like see a battle axe in there, quite a few daggers, short bow, a light crossbow, a long sword. You see a couple sets of leather armor, a set of studded leather armor, and you see some chainmail. You see a couple other, like scrolls, spell scrolls, but they are not in the greatest of repair.
I'm gonna grab that battle axe and the suit of studded leather armor.
All right, perfect.
And the two of the daggers.
Perfect.
Do you need studded leather armor? I was trying to buy you glamored studded leather.
No, it's just in case something happens to your armor rocket.
Oh, well, I appreciate that. Always thinking ahead. That's why you're my knight, Clem.
Oh, yeah. I got this intelligence now. Gotta use it.
At least one of us does, brother.
Alrighty. So what you guys up to now?
Ask the goblins if they know anything about the layout here. Like what to watch out for.
This is always... You gotta worry about Zendra. Them's got a couple of bases or the Xanathar, them's got a couple of bases around here, and then there's a Zentrum outpost going in the southerly direction. Of course, the monsters. You gotta always worry about the monsters. There's Glendaware rats. There's more monsters. And traps. There's lots of traps. Also, sometimes the mad mage just turns up and murders people. So, everything. Just gotta worry about everything.
All right, so same as the first floor.
Oh, yeah, I mean, you've been through the first level. It's same, but different.
So why do you people still live down here?
Well, we can't rot. They go up top and live in the city, right?
I mean, there's more to the top than just the city.
Oh, yeah, but we's from the Underdark. This is part of our lifestyle. Right, Elodia.
Rocket.
You see what at first startles you. And after a moment, you realize that, they're just stuffed. As you see, a 6 life-size goblins who looked as though they were killed in battle. Stuffed and taxidermied, with a beholder stuffed and taxidermied in the middle of the room. There's also a chest down to one side, as well as a few other random treasures. There's an ivory chessboard on a low stone table, and a 9-foot-tall, 3-foot-wide framed painting of Yek, which was the goblin. With the circle
in his hand, to make it look like a human. I want to check that chest, if possible.
Say what?
I want to check the chest, if possible.
Alright. There is 2,000 silver pieces inside of that chest.
Okay. Cool. I'm going to close the chest and walk out that room.
All right.
Possible to get past these 2 bugbears down here?
Bro, I'm taking the silver, by the way. I didn't mention that. I should have.
Yeah, I figured you'd be taking that. And yes, they get out of your way.
Let me go check this body that already left us. See how much body.
And they take their appropriate places.
Hello.
Your Majesty.
My name's King Rocket. What may I address you as?
Brubble Nitznitzel.
Right. I'll call you Dude and Bro.
That's fine. What is a bro?
It is you.
Alright. Bro means Brumble. It's good. That's good. Alright.
Yeah, exactly. Bro could also mean anyone else that I'm referring to, but if I'm calling for Bro, and I look at you, then I am referring to you. If I say, oh, bro, I'm not necessarily speaking to you. I know this is probably confusing, but, you'll get it.
We need to take 5 as laptop time.
Oh, okay. I'm going to run and hit a smoke break real quick then.
Alrighty.
Shout out to Darth, always tuning in, You're the man, dude.
Oh, yeah. Well, we will be back, everybody. A little short intermission here.
Rockets king.
Rockets getting a little too high and mighty.
Yeah, I literally see no one in my party around me that will like deter
There's
me
no one
to
within
do
range
otherwise. So, you know, I'm just sitting there like with this little vial in my hand, just like shaking it in front of me, like, you know, is this real? Like, what is going on? I like take my crown off and like,
it's all real. It's real, sir. I promise.
I said that out loud. Yeah. I know it's real. And I put the crown like back on my head real quick. But I'm still just sitting there with the pixie dust, like, how real is it though? Like, just in my head, kind of spinning it around.
Oh, you're also checking the body of the dwarf?
Yeah,
there's nothing left on it. He's gotten everything off of it.
I would like to tell them about this beholder. The stuffed beholder in this room, though.
Yeah, there is.
I figured that's something.
There
that,
is the stuffed beholder that. In there. There's the ivory chessboard and the tall painting.
Whenever they come back, I want to let them know about that room.
I will say the stuffed corpses are all in like costumes.
It's not there. Never mind.
What are you up to, Virgil?
I'm just kind of waiting until we leave this area.
Are these like paintings or something on the wall here?
That there is a big ass pile of cushions.
Everybody needs a pillow room?
Yeah.
It's a pillow room.
I'm gonna grab one of those. The nicest one.
They're all pretty nasty.
These are goblins. They ain't clean.
These are goblin pillows.
I'm gonna grab one kind of like this and just take it over to Rocket.
Okay, perfect.
I needed this.
Where's Revy?
You might want to do that thing.
Oh, yeah. Obviously.
Revy is waiting for you guys because he said he's going to stick with you, and he is itching to go punching some more stuff.
Hey, me too, Revy.
So I take Elodia's earpiece and put it in my ear as I like have my earpiece sitting on the throne. And I go to both the bugbears next to me up there. And I'm like, so, and I like show them how to use it and make sure that they can like talk back and forth to me through that. I say, no, we have some stuff we have to go take care of. So I'm not going to be in this room over here. You're in charge while I'm not in here.
Both of the bugbears go, all right, Roger, that I'm in charge. No, I'm in charge. He said,
bro. And I point at the one that I specifically called bro earlier.
Yeah, see, I told you he meant me.
Yeah, dude.
He said, bro.
Dude.
But bro means everybody.
Listen. Just because I say bro, I may be talking to anyone, but when I say bro and I point at bro, I'm only talking to bro.
This is very confusing concept. I just don't understand it.
Listen, dude, all you need to know is that if I'm talking to a dude, I'm only talking to you.
Oh, I'm special then. Yeah, you just want everyone else over there, bro. Yeah.
Yes, dude. What I need you to do is be his second. Like, if bro dies... sorry, bro.
Why would bro die?
Do you want me to kill bro? No, please don't kill bro. But just know that if bro dies, dude, you are in charge. Now, please don't...
If by some random happenstance something bad might happen to bro, then I'm in charge.
Exactly. But if I find out you're the one, you're the dude that killed the bro, then you are no longer a bro. And I will kill you.
That sounds terrible.
So, dude, your job is get bros, make if bro dies for whatever reason, you are now bro. Does that make sense?
No.
All right. You see this headpiece?
It's a little piece to what looks like it might be metal, but it's squishy.
Yeah, and I like take out mine and I like show it to him like this is the earpiece. This is what I'm talking about. Do you understand?
That is a piece of your ear, and it is a very weird piece of ear.
You're exactly right. I am not normal. I am a fucking king.
Well, it's ears, so of course I could never understand king's ears.
Exactly. So all you need to know is that bro's orders is to kill anything that comes in here thinking that it's the king. Or, anybody that comes in and attacks the market. His orders are going to be to do that. Your orders are to have his back. But if things are looking rough, then you're to grab the piece of my ear and put it in your ear and touch it. And then speak to me. Because that's how it works. I don't expect you to understand what that really means, but all you need to know is if you put that in your ear and you touch it, I can hear you. And if that happens, I will get back here as fast as I possibly can. But until then, you're in charge. And see, what bro doesn't know is that, see, okay, here's the ticket. I'm gonna tell bro that he's in charge, but really I'm counting on you, dude.
All right, I understand all that. I am the important one. I'm the one to do the ear touches.
But
how am I supposed to do the ear touches if I'm holding onto his back? He's got a large back. It will take two hands.
I don't literally mean to hold onto his back.
How am I supposed to get his back?
You watch it. You watch his back.
Just his back. It's going to be a boring day.
Listen. I know this is a lot to wrap your mind around right now. We're working with some deceit and things like that that you're probably not ready for, but I have faith in you. You know, I have faith in you, and I know that you can do this. Basically, I'm gonna tell bro that bro is in charge, and I'm telling you, dude, that if something happens to bro, it is imperative, very important, that you let me know. The way that you let me know is with that earpiece. I'm also going to tell Bro, if something happens, to use this earpiece. But if you notice that Bro is going towards the earpiece and he's not going to make it, it's your job to get that earpiece. If I have to come back here and find out that neither dude or Bro notified me on the earpiece, well, there's going to be a motherfucking problem, mate. You understand that?
All right. So just whatever I do, I keep an eye on the back of Bro.
And you can keep your eye on not just his back, but what he's doing. You know, what if I don't trust Bro? I trust you. So I need you.
Oh, of course, dude is the best.
What? I like that attitude. So what I need from you, dude, is to know that if Bro doesn't get back here to this earpiece, that you're going to get to it.
Should I just carry it in?
No.
In your pocket?
No, because again, I'm gonna tell Bro that his job is to make sure to let me know if anything happens on this earpiece. But your job,
even though you know Bro is going to die, because you need Dude to do it, because Dude is going to live.
Dude has to be on the same team as Bro. Can you be on the same team as Bro?
I can be on the same team as Bro, but you said Bro is going to die, and so Dude has to
do it. Oh, no, no. I said if.
Oh, if.
That's a very important word.
That's a possibility, which there's, I've heard there's a lot of those.
That's what I've heard as well. That's why I'm really counting on you.
I don't bother myself with them.
Can I count on you, dude?
Yes, you can count on me. Do you want to use my back? You want to use my arm?
No, I don't necessarily want to count any piece of your body. I just want to know that I can count on Dude and Bro to make sure that things are going well while I go help my friend over there. And I point over to Revy.
This is one of those things where you say a word and it doesn't mean what the word really means.
So
I don't understand how you would count on me if you didn't count on me.
What I need from you, dude, is just your word as a bugbear.
Why?
That if, let's see this word, that's that word again, if something happens to Bro, and I point directly at the other bugbear over there.
That one.
If something happens to that Bro, that my dude is gonna get the job done.
All right. And the job is earpiece, ear touch. I tell you what's going on. Also, running or fight. Run or fight.
Well, see, here's the thing. After you run to the throne where this earpiece is going to be, what I need you to do at that point is fight. So first we run, then we fight.
Okay, run, earpiece, ear touch, fight.
You're getting it. I knew I could count on you. You're my dude.
He's almost smart, dude.
You are the smartest dude in here.
No, I am probably the smartest dude in here.
I would be willing to bet you were. I count on you, dude. Can I count on you?
Oh,
not like literally count on you, but can you do the job that I'm asking you?
The thing with the words don't mean what they say. Yes, this, I can do that.
Perfect. Because if not, Rochelle here is going to eat your nuts.
Well, nuts, not my knickers. I like those.
All of them. She loves nuts.
Oh, God. Well, Rochelle, I can get you a lot of nuts. Some of them is roasted right over there.
No. She likes live nuts.
Live nuts?
Raw.
Think about
she likes them juicy.
Juicy nuts. It's terrible.
Yeah, yeah. It's not a pretty picture. I didn't want to paint that for you. I just can't think about.
Just okay. I got to keep a hold of his back, and then I'll have to make
piece. Once again, we're not holding his back. You're just gonna have eyes on him.
Oh, I mean,
not
yes.
like literal I've eyes.
Keep watching his eyes.
You
watching you know, his back with my eyes.
You watch him. You watch the dude watches the bro.
Rocket, dude. I'm going to murder your bodyguard.
Clint Thug comes up and grabs Rocket and be like, I think they got it, Rocket.
Clem, I really don't. I think they're fucking idiots.
Yeah. But, Sire, we must attend to patronage.
This is true. This is true. My knight has spoken. We must attend to our friend here. Bro. You.
They both say, what?
No, not you, dude. Not you.
Oh, yeah, all right.
Bro. Your job is to watch the throne. And if anybody comes near the throne, you pick up the earpiece and you put it in your ear and you touch it and you say, King Rocket, you need to get back here. Can you do that?
I got a question. If I'm watching the
Jesus
throne,
Christ.
How am I going to see him coming up? Because if you're watching the throne, you know.
Well, you have to use your peripheral. You keep the throne in your peripherals? Do you know what a peripheral is? Okay.
Perforation.
So I'm sorry, Clem, just one moment. So you eyes on me. You see me, right? You see me?
Oh, I see you. I see you.
All right, so keep looking at me. Keep looking at me. Clem, will you wave your hand in the air?
Yeah. So wave my hand.
All right, bro, do you're looking at me, right? You're looking at me?
I'm looking at you, yeah.
You feel the feeling in your eyes where you want to look over here at me, Mike, raising his hand, waving it around?
Listen to my king. I'm a good bro.
I understand. But I need you to keep your head on a swivel. I need you to keep your head on a swivel. You know what that means? It means you need to be looking all the way.
Is the neck all the swivel? Ways.
Rocket, the metaphor.
You just need to keep an eye on... You know what? Dude, bro, you know what? You guys just watch the market. If anybody comes into the market, both of you race over here to the earpiece. If you guys fight over the earpiece, we're going to have words. I'll tell you right now, we have words.
I'll have words.
Not as many as I do. I'll tell you what.
Probably not.
I guarantee you don't. I don't even know if you know what guarantee means. But I guess what? If you guys are fighting over this earpiece, and I'll hear you fighting over the earpiece. I can hear everything coming out of the earpiece. So if I hear you fighting over the earpiece, I'll fucking kill the both of you. You guys work together. You're a goddamn team. And you know what? We're all under the Sadler banner. All right? We all work for Rudy's. And you are all employees of Rudy's. And you are subjects of the king. So I'm going to leave with my friends here. And if anything fucking happens in here, I'll fucking kill the lot of you. You see that? And I point over to the ashes on the ground. And I say, you see that?
I've got a question. You said the whole market now, not just the throne. That's it. It's actually a lot easier. You can see the whole market. We can see the...
Please. Please keep an eye on the goddamn market.
Oh,
but also...
Yeah, sure.
if anybody sits on the throne, fucking kill them.
Well, yeah, because then they would destroy the ear touch thing.
Exactly, and that is very important. Now, what is going to happen now?
Your chair. We can't have anyone.
Plimtok's going to pick up Rocket and start walking on.
Hey, you want us to stop him from doing that? Is he not supposed to touch the king?
No, he's my knight. He can take me wherever he wants. But I tell you, you got to watch it. Animals, come on. Come on, animals. And like my animals follow. But until we leave, like Rocket is still just jabbering at them and trying to explain to them what to do, but contradicting himself by the words he's saying. And
they like kind of start like going forward, but then stopping and like going back towards the throne, like because like torn, they're like, they know they have to stay by the throne. They also have to watch the whole area. They also have to stop anyone from doing anything to the throne. They also have to stop anyone from coming inside. They don't know what delegating is.
I'll figure it out, Rocket, I promise.
I fucking hope so. Fucking idiot.
Oro, we love you, King. What are we supposed to do? I don't fucking know.
And you yell back, get back to work.
Yeah, like, you already have heard, like, during your conversation, you heard Hammerwork start up again. Most of the people at the stalls, like, went back to their stalls, and there's a couple less patrons there, a couple less shop owners, a couple new shop owners.
I imagine at least a couple goblins gathered up for that conversation and are just as confused.
Okay.
Oh, yeah, 100%. They're like, it's a murmur going through the hallways, like, what's going on? I don't know. We're supposed to watch the market, but we're supposed to watch each other's backs or have each other's backs, but it's your back.
I hold your back. You hold her back.
Or we'll just do a circle, or we'll just hold each other's backs, then we'll have each other's backs. It'll be perfect.
On the way around the corner, I'm like, it's called the massage train. Just handle it.
Handles? We don't have handles on our backs. This king is so much. There's just so much to work for.
Fucking idiots.
I'm so stressed. I'm so stressed. This is just so much.
Things might have been better under the other king. I don't know.
The thing is, the other king was just as dumb as they are.
I'm just a little too smart with my 10 intelligence.
Yeah.
Yeah, you know what's funny, though? Is the goblins also have a 10 intelligence, but the bugbears only have an 8.
Yeah, the bugbears are just strong and hold that respect factor.
Perhaps we should have put a goblin in charge of the microphone.
That's not goblin logic. They're going to do whatever the bugbears say.
I mean, the bugbears were only there because they were hired, right? Are they going to expect you to pay them when you go back?
Fuck the bugbears. I'll fucking kill them. Or Clem will do it.
I'll kill him.
See?
God damn it.
Out of honor, of course.
Yeah, totally. That's exactly where that comes from.
Clem respects the king. He knows what it is. That's a corner, Clem. Put me down.
This is speaking, which put me down.
Sorry.
It's just Clem just carrying you off.
I was distracted.
I just mount Rochelle.
Why'd you
right, Elodia.
Tiger Rochelle?
What you see there is
she's a beast.
It's you see a hallway
with Harry
leading to your south, and the goblins have gotten back to work on building what looks like a stage of some sort. Klimtok. See a doorway there.
Kick it in. No, I'm just kidding. I'm just gonna open it regularly.
Okay, cool. That also worked. You see a gibbet. And you hear, oh, please help.
Saw what now?
gibbet. It is a it's a form of a cage. Okay. Very small, slim, close to the body, hangs on a chain.
I'm gonna approach it.
So anyway, I stopped four gibbets.
Inside of one of them is a goblet.
Rocket, no one.
How smart are you?
Talking to me or the goblin?
The goblin.
Okay.
Oh, you say what's the name?
No, I said how smart are you?
As in the goblin?
Yeah.
Yeah. What do you want?
Intelligence is my dumb stat.
You're gonna let me out of here?
Why are you in here? I mean, it doesn't really matter one way or the other. This guy's the king now.
Oh yeah, did you bring Rocket in there with you?
I just marched through the room. You're goddamn right, I'm the king, as I keep going forward towards Elodia.
Oh.
Hey, Rocket.
Your Highness, maybe you could give me some food.
I ain't doing shit. And I keep going.
Oh, yes. Okay.
I'll give him a rest.
Is this goblin like frail and old?
They're very frail. Yes. Old. You can't quite tell it's a goblin. You're not quite sure how their anatomy works, but they definitely are young and spry.
I give him a ration.
Oh, thank you. So it's just like nomming it down. She is digging it.
I'll pick the lock on the cage.
You're gonna pick the lock on the cage? What?
Why not?
I bounced.
Yeah, go right in.
Yeah. My bear's sitting there looking at you like, what the fuck are you doing? I love that these animals are going to be here until dawn the next day, then they're just going to disappear.
Yeah, you're a fucking menagerie.
Yeah. I'm just all of a sudden going to be prancing along on this tiger, and it's just going to disappear, and I'm going to be like on the ground. Just, not moving anymore, just like,
Ow. Oh, tailbone.
Well. Tailbone. I got a high enough dex, I'll land. It's also a plus zero.
Yeah, that is true. You unlock the cage, and she goes, Oh, thank you. Thank you so much. What can I do to repay your kindness? I know this place rather well. I could guide you if you would offer to give me some more of the delicious yum-yums that you offered me a moment ago.
I was just doing it because you look like you've seen some shit, and the king is dead, so, you know, there's really no reason.
The king is dead?
Yeah.
No. But
maybe we could get more food for them. Wait, the king is not dead? Shit, put me back in the cage.
That's different king.
Different kings? Oh,
that's King Rocket, not King Dumbass.
New king! All hail the new king!
Yeah, goddamn right.
Yes, your majesty. Super deep, deep bow. Now, as I said,
that's a talent. She can kiss the floor.
Yum yums. All the way down, actually. It is not a problem. I can at least nose brush on a good day.
If I was single, whew.
So, your majesty, I could guide you through this cavernous way and help you on your way for just mere scruples.
I want to tap the dead guy and be like, yo, we kind of got a guide for the moment.
But kill people this way, it is out that way.
Yeah, so if we need anything, we'll probably circle back around because we know this area is safe.
Well, you see, you may have this thing, but I could help you know the. Okay, it's I don't have much against large undead zombie juggernaut, but if you need some help, come back by.
Yeah, just get the fuck out of the cage. Just go hang out in the market or something.
Nonsense, bring her with.
What'd you say?
Nonsense, bring her with.
Oh, yes, your highness. I would love to come with you as long as I get some more scrumdiddlyumptious.
Oh, God.
I don't know what that means, but, Elodia. You are in charge of that one.
That's kind of fun.
That's the worst idea you ever came up with, but yeah, let's do this.
All right. I'm down.
I'm giving Elodia control of that token.
Perfect.
All right.
If it, I like whisper to Elodia, like, if it dies, like, you just whoop. That's, you know, right? That's what you want, right?
Don't worry. I threw some goblins in the bag earlier.
Perfect.
I'm
waiting for this hole to come crashing down, I'll be honest. But until then, I'm just going to keep throwing orders out there.
I love how you're like a much less confident bard than most people.
You know, like, I put up a good front. But deep down I know, like, yeah, this might not work. But I have faith in Clem and right. Virgil and Elodia. I got faith in my people, you know? Like, and that's... I just hope that I can inspire them enough to where things happen the way they should, and we all make it out of here.
So, Glom does know the general layout of the underground, of this level. She knows where all the Xanathar Guild outposts are. And she knows how to get down to level 3. She tells you all this. Obviously, she says, of course I can tell you all of these things. No problem, I just need some more of the scrumdiddlyumptious yum yums. Some more of the grubbin hubs. Some more of nom noms, if you will.
How about I give you this quill, and you mark everything on this map here that we just got off of, we liberated off of a dwarf.
Meanwhile, I'm eating a ration. Like, what are you talking about? What is scrumdiddly umptious?
She's like looking at the map you have. Umptious. Drooling a bit. And
don't drool on the map. That's gross.
She's like, this map is not this level. This appears to be level 3, at least from the entrance here.
Well, 3. I mean, what? So, do you know your way around here?
Oh, yes, I know this entire floor.
No, so, that's even better if this map is for level 3. Because I don't think this guy's going to go past level 2.
Must kill them this way. New friends, let's go kill them.
Oh, get right. We're supposed to be we should follow Revy now. Right?
If Revy's moving, we follow.
I will kill them.
All Onward and yonward.
Like we're all marching.
I'm just trying to act as noble as fuck. Never having done that in my life before.
He heads towards the southern door. Which I have to read things.
I greet each goblin as I go past with a nod and a what I assume a noble would do. Blessings upon you. Blessings upon your market. Blessings upon you. Blessings upon your barrel? Is that... You know what? I don't even care. Blessings upon you. Blessings upon you.
Door. Okay. I kick. Just... through the door.
Jesus Christ, you just kicked through that door. Graham, isn't that your job?
He's got it.
Alright, well, you know, I'm just following behind you. Rocket and Rochelle do, like, just stay within Clem's little aura. As soon as they go anywhere, like, I feel like he feels like the warmth of the aura, so wherever Clem goes is where Rocket and Rochelle are at.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, yeah, I got you.
Cool. And Into or the baboon and the bear just kind of moseying along.
It's still this way.
Rochelle actually moves faster than the bear and the baboon, but I think faster than Clem. And so she can keep pace. I gotta look at the speed of the baboon and the bear, but I think they go as fast as Clem.
Yeah, the baboon and the bear both easily have a 30 foot. I'm pretty sure the poor bear has a 40 foot.
Yeah, the baboon can actually climb 30 feet and has 30 foot speed, so it can get there for sure. The bear actually has 40 foot, so yeah, he can get wherever. Oh, and the bear has multi-attack. That's the one.
The bear has multi-attack, yes.
Yeah.
And they just buffed the bears too.
They can go single file. They're fine. None of them are large except for Rochelle.
All right. You have gone to a set of collapsed tunnels of some sort. Odd. They are dug out, but they're dug out well.
So, like,
okay, so, yeah, that doesn't tell me a lot. Okay, so, yeah. All right, he keeps going. It's this way. Coming into that room, it is a room where the walls are painted with images of wizards succumbing to madness and being transformed into nothics. One particularly vivid image shows shafts of eerie green light exploding out of a spellbook and changing a wizard into a gibbering mouther.
Ew. That mural is gross as fuck.
All right. He walks in. And, Klimtok, you being right behind him, you see a woman lounging on a couch. And she sits up and she goes, "Now you... Oh, my." He goes, "Die." Roll initiative.
Rocket is king.
Okay, so all right, Rocket, you're first, and you see this lady on the couch. She's lounging. Now in the process of sitting up quickly as Revy is just making a beeline straight for her.
Scale of 1 to 10 as far as the beauty aspect goes.
She's pretty.
Okay. But Revy looks like it's... This is it, right?
Oh, this is it.
Cool.
You're a married man.
Oh, I'm aware.
Fidelity's bad. He's a married man out of the dungeon.
No. I say to her as I viciously mock her, "You may be beautiful, but you're so ugly into that skin." And she needs to make a wisdom save under 18.
Okay.
Or take 4 points of psychic damage.
It's a 16, so she takes 4. Next it will be Virgil.
Looks like she was just in here watching TV or something.
She's literally just laying on the couch, homie.
Shit, there's a lot of people in here. I don't want to use my last spell slot. And doing the bonus action. Made that smaller, please. All right, get it right there and go for the attack.
All right. Whack of mole. Yep, the hits.
Lemon slash.
She is real hurt now.
All right, I only got the one attack right now.
All right. That brings us to her. She She has spirit guardians. There's a number of strange, impish, and demonic figures start to rise from around her, dance and sing.
What the fuck is that?
Was questioning, you know, following a revenant around, doing its bidding, killing random people. But now I'm kind of on his side.
Yeah. Fiendish creatures start to dance around her and sing, and she steps up towards you, and oh shit, I could have done that. That would have hurt really bad if she would have hit, but instead, make a wisdom saving throw. Virgil. That is a save. And I'm pretty sure that saves you from... Oh, you still take half as much damage. So you take 5 necrotic damage. She says, "Huh? Now,
what come did she target?"
Say what?
What did she target?
Whatever, whichever essence of you is right in front of her. There, it's Spirit Guardians. Oh shit, you can't see them. Spirit Guardians is a 15-foot radius. Around her, and anything that enters or after the spell is activated, and then anything that enters or starts its turn in that area has to make wisdom save or they take damage.
Okay, that was just my clone.
Okay, so that was the clone. That is now. Clibdock's turn.
All right. I'm gonna go for it.
Your speed. As you notice, as soon as you get within 15 feet, it seems as though you're trudging through deep water. One, make a wisdom save, and within 15 feet of her, it is rough terrain. You can only move half as far.
Okay. That's not good. So, there'd be 15 here. So, that is... I guess I can only move 5 more feet then.
Yeah, you'd only be able to get to there.
Wisdom save. I do get a +3 to that, if that helps. I doubt it.
It does not help. You do take 9 damage. Right. Necrotic, if that changes anything.
All right.
Always make your attack as a breath.
Yeah, I believe that's what I'm gonna do. Special. Ooh. Dang it. Okay. Okay, I'm gonna use my breath weapon. Okay, I'm gonna use my I went to Oklahoma schools. Innervating breath.
innervating. Yeah.
Yeah, I'm gonna use that. So it's a cone. Creature in the cone must succeed. I'm guessing it's 15 feet. The rest, same with the other ones. They need to make a con save DC 12 or become incapacitated until the start of my next turn.
That's a 7.
Oh yeah, so she is incapacitated.
Okay, so yeah, we'll just say that, Alodia, what do you want to do to this person? They do not have even if they, like, the damage of that breath, even if they save, is going to put them down to very, very low potions. They only have, like, 20 health left. So we'll give Alodia the kill shot this time.
Oh, I was just going to move and show touch her.
What?
Right there.
Well, yeah, it doesn't matter. One of you, at one point in time coming up very shortly, was going to kill this one. And if it wasn't you, then Revy was going to just pound her face in. So you could even say that you just hold your action until it's Revy's turn. To get his revenge that he wants ever so sweetly. Oh, wait, does that breath also do damage?
No.
Like a bunch of damage?
No, that
Okay, yeah.
Yeah, it replaces it.
Yeah, yeah, so that freezes her, and she had 12 health left, so. Your chill touch would bring her down at the very least. It's a D8, right? Yep. And then Revy would pound her face in right after that. So yeah, you would do some icky hands, as Shimmery would say, and then
not very hot now, are you?
No, she is not very hot at all anymore. She is now a brutalized corpse, mostly large indents in her skull and upper chest area again. Very similar to what looked like on that dwarf and the last guy that you guys saw. So, you guys are in a very nice room. Extremely nice. Ridiculously nice, even. The nicest room by far that you've seen in this entire dungeon.
All right, guys. King's orders. We block this off, and we take a nap.
I'm down.
Yeah, I need a nap.
Who's feeding the goblin?
Somebody has to feed the goblin. Ew.
Before, what you guys didn't notice is that there are trays of food floating around. There is a well-furnished table, fully stacked with a full spread. And in the short amount of time that it took her to die, the trays of food hadn't moved, and then they kind of like go and all the trays just get set on the table. And then Randy, yes. You said you are a king, you feel multiple tugs at your clothing from something that you can't see, or some things you don't know.
Are they trying to pull me in any specific direction?
Yes, they're pulling towards the table.
Okay. I like go over to the table, and the baboon like picks up a chair and throws it against the wall. And then like Rochelle comes and sits next to the table while I'm still just like sitting on it, like, yes.
And yeah, they lead you right up to the head of the table, and then food gets brought up and, like, tilted towards you, held for a second, if you don't say anything.
I like this room.
Gets set down, and the next one gets picked up, and it moves towards you, and it gets tilted towards you, and it holds there for a second.
Mr. Bear, will you block off the door, please? I assume
blocks the door off.
Yeah, I assume everybody's in the room. And yeah, like, I definitely would eat.
The lady have anything of worth?
On her is a holy symbol of Char. There is a holy symbol of Joaquin as well, which, Rock, as you're looking at it,
as fuck.
And as you pull it off, the symbol of Joaquin, the Revenant looks at it, and he snatches forward and he grabs it. And as soon as his hand touches it, he, like, looks forward and he kind of, like, releases, like, a breath. It's like, and then him and the symbol both dissipate in the dust.
Like that there.
Why'd he grab it?
I will say, above board, that was his symbol that was stolen off of him by her. And it was
he got it back.
Money and income. And he got one of the things that was stolen from him. And so his anger was satiated. And so therefore he was able to pass on.
So he's gone?
I thought he still had one more person to get.
He does have one more person to get, but he found his holy symbol, which reminded him of the teachings of his god, and that overrided his need for revenge.
Oh, well.
All right, I guess the last person gets off the hook.
Where the shit is...
The food is delicious, by the way.
Where did that guy go? Everybody know?
I guess he thought he was done.
He didn't think he was done. But when he touched his symbol, his god basically just dispelled him.
I think you're looking
at it.
There's also symbol of Char is very well made. It's probably worth about 25 gold pieces. There's also a small portrait of Alastar. It's 3 feet wide and 5 feet tall. It's not magical. It's worth money, though, probably.
That's a big painting, dude.
Yeah, it looks a very familiar wizard in a ridiculous pointy hat with stars on his robe. Looks to be mid-robe.
Just taking his holy symbol and looking at it, like, what happened to me?
No, you're the golden knight, Clem. It's fine.
All right, it is approaching the later afternoon now, and it has been a while, at least, since you guys have long rested last. You guys can take a long rest. Or, I should say,
I need a long rest.
Give a shot at it.
I was going to use my divine sense for a long rest.
So, 1 second.
I hate that we're about to long rest, like, with enough time for my animals to still be alive after the long rest, but they're going to just disappear shortly after we're done.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But you said they're 24 hours, right? Or is it just till the next dawn?
It's till the next dawn. At the next dawn, they just evaporate into thin air, but they, like, I have 3 more little Pokeballs in my bag. But I don't know if there'll be a bear and a tiger and a baboon. Yeah, yeah.
You'll just have
they might just be like fucking three weasels, and I'll be like, "Oh, shit,
son of a bitch!
I can't skate on these bitches out of here."
Okay. You do not sense anything because your divine sense, it doesn't go through walls, correct?
It does not.
Okay, yeah. So in the room, you don't sense anything undead or unholy or anything. I would say none of you are wizardly, so you guys probably wouldn't know what this spell is. Although, I would say Elodia has a chance on a good history check, or an arcana check, sorry, to possibly pinpoint what who is feeding Rocket food. Rocket, you could also, on a good arcana check, be able to figure it out.
I have a feat for this.
Can I give Elodia help?
Yeah.
Perfect.
Cool. Can I roll that first one at advantage?
Yeah, so you just roll another one.
And I want to use my luck point.
All right.
That I never used.
Okay. Believe...
That's way better.
...that these are unseen servants. They're different from what you understood them by, because... Unseen servants are normally cast, and then they only last for a certain amount of time, and if the user that cast them dies, they disappear forever. But this person was sitting there using them, and you killed her, and they're still here. They're still serving you. So you don't understand why they're still around, but you don't understand what they are.
Right, it looks like you have some invisible people helping you out now.
Their food is really good. All they're doing
right now is serving food.
Their food is really good. You guys should eat some of this. Like, I had a ration earlier, and I shouldn't have eaten that ration, because, like, this is fire.
Yeah, you guys do feel some tugs on your sleeves, as it feels like something is trying to pull you towards the table.
Rocket eats his fill, tells his animals to go watch the front, and takes a nap in the chair for sure.
All right, there's the big-ass couch. She has now vacated because, well, maybe she hasn't vacated yet. She might still be laying in it.
No, I'm 100% in this chair right here.
Oh, yeah. Ironically, all this stuff looks like Lazy Boy furniture, like chairs and the couch, all that just looks like just a bunch of big ass cushy chairs and stuff.
So, like, I don't want to like meta too much or anything, but like, how much longer until sunrise?
Man, so I would say it's getting into the evening now. So it's probably only like
8 at night. Like what season is it?
You guys are in the end of summer now.
All right, so it's long days, but they're getting shorter.
Yeah.
Okay, so sunrise is probably like 7-ish or like 6:30.
Yeah, probably around 6:30.
Okay.
So you probably still got like.
So I got like
eight. You guys wake up, you'll probably still have like a couple hours.
Couple hours. Got it. Not that I know what time of day it is or anything, but like. Yeah. Like I said, you know, I'm not trying to meta too much, but I just need to know as a player, like, what the reality of the situation is.
If you had taken the pixie dust, I'd probably tell you, you know, it could be now, it could be forever. Who knows?
Yeah, if I had taken the pixie dust, I wouldn't even be asking right now.
He'd just be petting fur, like, it's so yeah, soft. Just be
like, this is great. This food is awesome. Like, let's keep going. Let's keep going. Where'd Revy go? But
all right.
Yeah.
But yes, you guys can all take a long rest.
I'm gonna re-up all my skeletons also.
Alright, sounds good. Have you recovered all the necessary bones and such you need for that?
Yeah, I picked up goblins in the last room.
Alright, perfect. Alright, I'm about to go smoke a cigarette. It shouldn't die, but if it does, that's what happens.
I mean, I'm down to call it whenever you're down to call it. It's getting kind of late.
Yeah, it's kind of late.
Yeah. All right. This seems like a good spot to call it. So let's call it here.
Yeah, I mean, I'd rather call it here or taking a long rest than be like in the middle of a room or some shit like that, you know?
You discover a secret door and we'll call it there.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, sometimes that is the best time to call it, you know, like, because the players are like, what?
Yeah.
No, you know, like, but sometimes the best time has been like, yeah, you guys find a safe spot to chill for a minute.
And, well, you found a spot that you guys are pretty sure is safe to chill for a
minute. I have faith in Rochelle and Barry and Bernard.
Don't forget, you have your little goblin guide with you still.
Oh, yeah. No, I put that. Elodie's got that.
You're the.
Yeah.
I'm delegating. I am a king now.
Yeah.
Thank you guys
for all right.
Watching on stream.
Plus, weren't we supposed to see
hell it in yeah.
place so nothing could get in or out?
All right.
Huh?
What did you guys for watching. Thank you very much. Hope you guys come and join us again. Would love to see you guys come and follow us and like and subscribe, all that useless shit on YouTube. That'd be dope. Dungeon Oasis streams. It'd be sick if you came play with us on Discord. We'd really love that.
It would be super cool if we could get like what is that, verified on YouTube?
Yeah, that would be dope.
So we could just get a goddamn URL. That'd be great.
That'd be really cool.
But until then, search that shit and go like our stuff so we can actually get that.
That's it. But until then, you just gotta search up Dungeon Oasis streams. Look for Bob Moss.
You already know what it is.
Thank you. Good night.
Later, guys.